being said, go ahead and open up your Chromebooks for us, please, and go to our Google Classroom, find Unit 3. By the end of our time with our Cornell notes today, you should have the front page completed. Excellent. All right. Seeing that everybody's there, go ahead and click on the video and begin your Cornell notes.
All right, so we're going to be starting our next unit, which involves ratios, rates, and proportions, okay? And we're going to go through our Cornell notes process like we've done in the past.
Blended learning is when we're using technology along with the teacher inside the classroom to help facilitate our learning process and our objectives to the students, whatever that might be, you know, on a given day or during a given lesson. We use that method because it allows the students to engage directly with the video. So there's not a buffer between the teacher per se and the lesson being given or what's being talked about. It's right in their ear and right in their face. And so there are no opportunities for distraction.
So I was looking back at the sixth grade standards, because remember that guide we have that the secondary math put together where it talks about the standards that they should have already covered, the right standards that they're going to cover in eighth grade. So I was looking at last year's standards and I saw one big blaring difference. You know how it says here, compute unit rates associated with ratios of fractions, right, including ratios of length, areas, blah, 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 blah. So basically what it's telling us is the difference between sixth and seventh grade is in sixth grade, they would do rates such as like say,
we were going to begin a new unit of ratios and proportions, and we understand that students in the sixth grade, they were finding the unit rate using just whole numbers.
Nonetheless, we wanted to remind the students of the steps of finding the unit rate. And so we went about it through a blended classroom where the students were able to not only watch a video, take some Cornell notes, reflect on their thinking, but then collaborate also.
Hey class, how you doing? All right, so we're going to be starting our next unit, which involves ratios, rates, and proportions, okay? And we're gonna go through our Cornell notes process like we've done in the past. And so what you see me talking through here and also what you see me writing down, guess what you should be doing? That's right, you should be writing it down also, okay?
We made a video instead of just standing up and teaching it in front of the classroom for several reasons. If you look at recent studies of how people learn, namely students, middle school students, so they actually seem to have more engagement with the technology with videos. I mean, they'll watch a YouTube video of someone unpacking a box for 10 minutes and be able to regurgitate what that person did. So you're still going to do exactly what we did in sixth grade. You're going to create your ratio of 1/2/1/4 and make it a rate by adding your units.
And just so you know really quick, you guys, this was what we talked about earlier, a complex fraction, which means a fraction over a fraction.
There's okay, nothing fancy. We literally just, if one of us makes a video, we will literally hold it in our left hand and write at the same time.
After we record the videos on the phone, we upload them and we put them onto our Google Classroom, and students access them from there, and they're able to, you know, play as much as they want, rewind it, pause as the video is taking place while they're doing their Cornell notes.
The students take that time on the computer to watch that video and interact never more than 15 minutes. There will never be a video that will ever be more than 15 minutes because that's already, they've already lost engagement at that time. So before we get started, you guys see those things in red? Under examples, those are what we call stems. You can use those to start your sentences. If you got everything and you're like, no, I got this, Ms. Hernandez, I don't need any help, I'm Jose Torres, and I just like nailed that last problem. In fact, I did something extra that I didn't even need to do, then maybe he's gonna write a learning statement. But if you're me and you're like, oh, I kind of understand this, but I'm not understanding how to do this part, then write a question. So you write a question or you write a learning statement, okay? Aria. Stand up real quick, Mama.
A big part of our process that goes along with the video to ensure that it is something that is meaningful and purposeful is to have the students complete an assignment or activity at the same time. Not just complete that activity, but to also reflect on the process of them watching that video, the learning that's taking place, and, you know, perhaps the learning that's not taking place.
And I learned that you divide to get to a smaller number, and then you multiply to one.
To get to the, divide to get to the smaller, multiply to get to the.
One of the things that I had questions about from a few students mm-hmm. were that they saw that there were three fractions in their box in the end, and okay. they were thinking, all right, I have these three fractions, but how do I know when to multiply, or how do I know when I'm supposed to divide okay. to get an equivalent fraction?
Okay, keep going. I'm just writing notes.
Yeah, no, so I think the biggest question is, should I divide or should I multiply? Not realizing you can do both, or you can do either, or you can okay. multiply twice, or you can divide twice, depending on the fraction that you have and the size of the fraction.
Okay. In making a second video, what we normally do is by the end of class, during the whole entire class period, we're looking for errors. We're looking for misconceptions or mistakes.
We were able to determine where the struggle was. So with that, it's just maybe a 5-10 minute conversation and a 4-5 minute video, and we're able to address those, you know, struggles or challenges the following day when the students come in.
Good afternoon. When you come in, go ahead and open your Chromebooks. Make sure you're at a voice level of 0. Thank you for coming in quietly, and your starter is on the Google Classroom. So don't forget, you guys, you're doing the starter on the Google Classroom, but we want to see your work on your starter page. So you should be showing your work, how you came to that answer, and then you will type that answer into the Google Classroom, okay?
We do not have a big bank of videos that we've, say, pre-created to pull from. And the reason we don't do that is because each year our group of students has a different set of needs.
We have a specific objective, and that objective leads into to meeting the standard. And because of that, we make specific videos based on the objective for the day, based on the standard that we're wanting to meet. We know what we want, and so we just simply go backwards and create a document and create a learning tool in which the kids can use that to actually meet that standard or objective for the day. How many words does she type per minute? Per minute, meaning the number 1. That is our unit rate.